Hi, I'm back with part three. Jesus died for you so you can be saved. He allowed that curtain to be broken. He allowed the curtain of God. He allowed that curtain in the temple to fall, to break, as he died on the cross for you so you can be saved and your sins can be forgiven. Through the blood of Jesus Christ, you only have to cry out to God, just like Jesus cried out on the cross to his Father. Jesus, forgive God, as he cried out to his Father. Basically, as he cried out to his Father, and the earth shook and etc. At the moment the curtain of the temple was torn into two, from top to bottom, the earth shook and the rocks split. You know, the earth shook and trembled, and he tore that temple curtain in two, allowing us to be able to have a relationship with God. See, basically, he cried out to his Father. Will you cry out to God tonight? Will you cry out to Jesus and say, I want Jesus in my life? Now, if we go to 2 Corinthians 4. Now, in 2 Corinthians 4, if we went to verses 3, even if our gospel is veiled, just like before Jesus Christ was on the cross, before he cried out to his Father, and as he cried out to his Father, then the earth shook and the curtain was split in two. As it says in 2 Corinthians verses 4, and even if our gospel is veiled, it is veiled to those who are perishing. Are you perishing tonight? Do you feel that heavy weight of a curtain on you tonight? Because if you do, then you know, you'll know what Jesus was feeling, because when Jesus walked this earth, he understood the love. He understood about helping people, about serving people. He understood the heavy weight and the burden that was on him, the responsibility from his Father that why he was on this earth. He had a purpose, he had a plan, and at the end of it all, he was crucified. He was crucified, but not only that, he was not selfish. There was no selfishness about it. He was actually thinking about the people. The people had the choice and be able to have a relationship with the Father. But he shed his blood on the cross and was crucified so your sins will be saved. If you go to Matthew 1 and look at when Mary conceived this child from the Holy Spirit, and then Joseph was wanting to back out of it. And he went to sleep that night, and an angel of the Lord had come to him and said, Joseph, what's going on? You will take Mary home. Mary will have this baby, and you will call this baby Jesus, and this baby will be here for this purpose. And that purpose was just to save the sins of this world, to save the sins of the people. And obviously, if we go into Jesus' life and testimony, we can see what his purposes are. But what is your purpose tonight? As I've said in many other sermons, what is your purpose tonight? See, in 2 Corinthians, it's saying there, in 2 Corinthians verse 4, verses 3, and even if the gospel is veiled, it is veiled to those who are perishing. So if you're just willing to open up your eyes and willing to say, I accept Jesus Christ, I accept the word of God, I just listen to Jesus, I want Jesus in my life, then you will no longer perish. Because the perishing is of your old self, and when you give your life to Jesus, the perishing and your old self passes away, and you are born again in Jesus Christ. Your new life starts. You have a new life in Jesus. And you no longer have to worry about your old self, because that dies. You die for Jesus. You die to give your life to Jesus. You give up your old self and your old perishing self to be able to have that veil, like this, the curtain that was split in two. You're able to see behind that curtain. You're able to see in front of that curtain. You're able to see everywhere because you've decided to give your life to Jesus. In verses 4 it says, the God of this age has blinded the minds of unbelievers so they cannot see the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is an age of God. For we do not preach ourselves, but Jesus Christ our Lord, ourselves as your servants for Jesus' sake. For God, who said, let the light shine out of darkness, made his light shine in our hearts to give us light of knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Christ. In the glory of God in the face of Christ. In the face of Christ, God is sharing this message. And you may get something out of this word of God tonight that will touch your heart. And there may be darkness somewhere, and through the word of God, it's just like a torch shining into your darkness. And suddenly, God, you may start listening to God, and you might say, oh, there's my purpose and there's my reason. And I do not need to give my life to Jesus. Now, just moving on. See, just moving on into this is that we go on. I'd like to share something as well. The part of the reason this sermon tonight is because I go to church, and tonight we went to church because our old faithful car died and it went off to the wreckers. You know, these things happen. And because it went off to the wreckers, you know, being a Christian, etc., I like to go to church and I like to worship there with God. I don't go there for any other reason but to listen to the Word of God and to get a message from God. I don't go to church because of the pastor there or because of other people. I go there because of the Word of God and to also worship in God's house and to worship with other Christians. But I don't go certainly there just to be recognized. I give God all that glory and I give the glory to God. The glory is never ours. The glory is the glory to glory of God, not to do with us. But coming, walking to church tonight, it was very strange. And walking down the road, I know it's not good to hitchhike, but we decided to hitchhike a little bit, and suddenly this car went whoosh straight past us, and suddenly the brake lights came on, and my wife said, maybe they just missed the street where they had to go or the house, and they come back, guy wind his window down, he said, where are you going? And he said, oh, I can give you a lift. Suddenly we started talking, and they said they were Christians, and I said I was a Christian, and rah, 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 and I said, look, I'm going to church tonight, to this church, and they said, oh, we're going to this church. And I said, oh, it won't hurt. We've only been in town for a month. I said, oh, well, we'll come to your church. And why we're in the church, you know, God, as being a visionist and being a visionist for God and serving people and being there for listening to God and etc., while we're sitting there or standing there singing this song before the sermon, Jesus or God, the Holy Spirit, was talking to me. And I wrote these notes. I know they're not going to make sense, but when Jesus was on the cross, he died for you so your sins can be saved and that you can be forgiven. Before this, there was a temple, and in that temple was that curtain. And how we then started to enter in God's throne room. We're able to enter into God's throne room because Jesus Christ died on the cross for you. And it's just by just saying, look, I want Jesus Christ in my life tonight, or when you are ready to give your life to Jesus, then you can enter God's throne room because Jesus died on the cross for you. And you're able to have a relationship through Jesus. And you're able to have that relationship through Jesus and with God and the Holy Spirit. When Jesus was on the cross, he forgiven you. He forgives you. He loves you. And as I said, then the curtain in the church was torn down. So when he was on the cross, that curtain was torn down. And I was writing this before even the sermon started, and the sermon had some of this in it. But it's amazing how God's hand can be on a person. And sometimes, as this sermon tonight was on deja vu and etc., sometimes we don't want to listen to what's in our heart. Sometimes we don't want to listen to God. I'm going to leave it there, and I'm going to go to part three. And I'll be part four. So I'll be back with part four just in 1 second.